رمضان زمان البركات رمضان زمان الحسنات رمضان زمان البركات رمضان زمان الحسنات رمضان مجال الصلوات طوبى للنفس بتقواها
رمضان كريم 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 شهر عظيم 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 رمضان كريم 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 شهر عظيم 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 قم للعبادة تلقى السعادة قم للعبادة تلقى السعادة تلقى السعادة تلقى النعيم
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله الكريم صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين Beloved brothers and sisters, welcome to another episode of Islam the Natural Way. In today's presentation, Sheikh Abdool Aleem will speak to us on intensifying our efforts in the last 10 days of Ramadan. First, here is Brother Fadil Bakos with a recitation from Al-Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسله ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم صدق الله العظيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا متقبلا يا رب العالمين آمين Beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As for non-Muslim guests, may the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with all of you. Beloved brothers and sisters, ayyaman ma'dudat. These are the words which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the month of Ramadan with. A few days, a few fixed number of days. And subhanallah, these days have come and they are going ever so quickly. Bil amsi kunna naqul ramadanu ahlan wal yawma naqul ramadanu mahlan. Yesterday we were saying welcome Ramadan, ahlan Ramadan. Today we are saying slow down Ramadan, mahlan, slow down, take your time, let us get some more time with you. Subhanallah, 2/3 of the month of Ramadan is gone already. And we have now entered into the last third of the month of Ramadan. It is our state at this point in time should be like someone who has a beloved guest who has visited him. And the time is coming when that person will be about to leave. So we want to cherish every moment that we have remaining with that beloved guest, because he has brought so much good to us. We have been so happy for this period of time that he has spent with us. So we want to utilize every moment we can to benefit, to bring some sort of benefit to ourselves, to feel the happiness and the joy and to really cherish these moments that remain before that beloved guest is gone. And therefore, beloved brothers and sisters, our attitude in these last days of the month of Ramadan, in this last third of the month of Ramadan, must be one of really intensifying our efforts, of pushing ourselves. For those who have worked hard in the past days of the month of Ramadan, alhamdulillah, this is the opportunity to increase, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in His infinite mercy, He has made these days of the month of Ramadan the best days. The last days and nights, the last 10 days and nights of the month of Ramadan are the best days and nights of Ramadan. They are the most blessed. And therefore, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when these days entered, he used to make more effort. Kana sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yajtahidu fil ashri al-awakhiri ma la yajtahidu fi ghayriha. Aisha radiyallahu anha said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in these last 10 days and nights of the month of Ramadan, he used to push himself to do more than he did in the first two-thirds of the month of Ramadan. And we know how much the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to push himself in the first place. But when it came to this last part of the month of Ramadan, he pushed himself even more. And in the other narration, إِذَا دَخَلَ الْعَشْرُ كَانَ صَلَّى عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إِذَا دَخَلَ الْعَشْرُ أَحْيَى اللَّيْلِ وَأَيْقَظَ أَهْلَهُ وَجَدَّ وَشَدَّ الْمِئْزَرُ. That when these last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan came, he would stay up most, if not all of the night, and he would wake his family, all of those who could stay up or could stand up at night and pray Salatul Tahajjud, extra salah, extra ibadah, he would wake all of them. He would go around to the different rooms and he would wake all of them. He would pass by the dwelling of Ali radiallahu anhu and his wife Fatima radiallahu anha, the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he would awaken them and he would say, Ala tusalliyan, will you not get up and pray salah? He would wake all of them in these last 10 nights to pray extra salah. Wajadda, and he would push himself more. Washadda al-mi'zar, and he would tighten his waistband. He would push himself as much as he could in these last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan, because they are the most blessed, and especially because in them is the most blessed night of the year, Laylatul Qadr, the night of decree, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made more blessed for the one who witnesses it than 1,000 months of worship. 1,000 months of worship, more than 83 years of worship in one single night, one single blessed night that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed in these last 10 nights. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would push himself more in these last 10 nights, and he would push those who are around him, his household, his family members, to do more, to make more effort, so that inshallah they would not be deprived of this good. Beloved brothers and sisters, there are so many who witness the month of Ramadan and it brings no change in their lives. Subhanallah, what a loss. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he made that dua, when he was ascending the minbar, and he said, Ameen. And when he was asked about it, and he said, Jibreel alayhi salam came to him and said that whoever witnesses the month of Ramadan and he allows it to slip away without gaining the forgiveness of Allah, then may he be distanced. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ameen. May Allah answer that dua. This is a serious dua, subhanallah. Because the goodness of the month of Ramadan is so abundant that nobody who makes any effort can really miss it. It would really take total negligence on the part of the believer, on the part of the Muslim, to ignore and to miss the blessings and the goodness of the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from that state. If we truly understood the blessings of the month of Ramadan, we would want to seize every moment of it. But let us not be like those people who are complacent in the most of the month, or if not all of the month, and at the end of it, then they regret and they say, I wish I had taken advantage of it. I wish it could come back to me again. We do not guarantee that we will live to see another month of Ramadan. Now is the time to push ourselves. Al-Imam Ibn Rajab Al-Hanbali rahimahullah, in his book Lata'if Al-Ma'arif, in which he speaks about the actions that should be performed in the various months of the year, and he mentions in the month of Ramadan, when he comes to the end of the month of Ramadan, bidding farewell to the month of Ramadan, he mentions some couplets of poetry, in which he shows the example of the person who does not take advantage of this month, and at the end of it he regrets. And he says, أَتَتْرُكُ مَنْ تُحِبُّ وَأَنْتَ جَارُ وَتَطْلُبُهُمْ إِذَا بَعُدَ الْمَزَارُ. Do you leave and abandon the person you love when he is visiting you, when he is close to you, when he is right next to you? Do you become preoccupied and too busy so that you do not spend time with him? You do not gain of the goodness of being around him. And then when he is gone, then you run in a frenzy to search for him, to see where he is gone. You don't know where he is gone, but now you try searching for him. وَتَبْكِي بَعْدَ نَأِيهِ مُشْتِيَاقَ وَتَسْأَلُ فِي الْمَنَازِلِ أَيْنَ سَارُ. And you cry when they have gone away, because now you yearn for their presence and for their company, and you're asking all around in the dwellings in the neighborhood, أَيْنَ سَارُ, where have they gone? تَرَكْتَ سُؤَالَهُمْ وَهُمُ حُضُورُ وَتَرْجُوا أَن تُخَبِّرَكَ الدِّيَارُ. You didn't ask them when they were present where they're going, when they're going, and now that they have gone, now you're asking all of the dwellings around and you hope that they can tell you. فَنَفْسَكَ لُمْ وَلَا تَلُمِ الْمَطَايَا وَمُتْ كَمَدًا فَلَيْسَ لَكَ اعْتِذَارُ. You can only blame yourself. Don't blame your mount, because it can't take you fast enough or far enough to reach to that guest. He's gone. You can't find him again. Don't blame anyone else but yourself. And suffer in silence, because you have no excuse. This is the state of the person who neglects the month of Ramadan until it is gone, and then wishes that it could come back again so that he could benefit from it. Let us not be like that, beloved brothers and sisters. Then there are those who, they begin the month of Ramadan with energy, with speed, at a good pace, and after a little while, they start to become exhausted. The pace weakens, and as we say, they burn out, and they stop making effort. So maybe the first week, maybe the first 10 days of the month of Ramadan, they're busy. And then after that, they fail to do good. They start to weaken. The pace starts to falter. And as they come closer and closer to the end of the month of Ramadan, they start doing less and less and less. And then they're just waiting for one specific night to stand up and hope that they witness Laylatul Qadr and they get all of the good of the month of Ramadan. It should be the opposite way around, beloved brothers and sisters. The month of Ramadan for us should be like a long distance race that we're participating in. We start off at a pace that is manageable, and we move with the others. And as we start coming to the end of the race, the last laps of the race, then we start intensifying and picking up the speed, picking up the pace. And this is where we are right now with the last 10 days and nights of the month of Ramadan. This is the time when the Prophet ﷺ picked up the pace and he pushed himself more and he pushed those around him. And this is the time we need to push ourselves more, beloved brothers and sisters. Shaykh Al-Sa'di rahimahullah, in his tafsir, he mentions that the example of the person who makes a lot of effort at the beginning of the month of Ramadan, and then he weakens towards the end of the month of Ramadan, is like a person who sows a seed. He plants a seed, he waters it, he takes care of it, and the plant grows. He nurtures it, it blooms, and it begins to bear its fruits. And just as the fruits begin to ripen and the time comes close for him to harvest the fruits, he leaves the plant and he goes away. He just abandons it. There seems to be no sense in that action. And this is the situation or the state of the person who in the month of Ramadan makes some effort in the beginning and then becomes preoccupied, becomes bored, becomes exhausted, becomes tired, and therefore fails to make the effort that is necessary towards the end of the month of Ramadan to really and truly benefit from all of the goodness that is there. In this last part of the month of Ramadan, beloved brothers and sisters, this night that is better than 1,000 months, that is better than 83 years of worship, it deserves all of the effort we can make to seek it. And let us not adopt the attitude of putting all of our eggs into one basket. Many people ask and they want to know, which is Laylatul Qadr? What is the night of decree? Is it the 27th night or the 29th or the 25th? So they look, what are the odd nights? And then they try from there to reduce the amount of nights to come to the specific night. Is it the 27th night or which one is it? So they will make effort on that one night. That is putting all of our eggs into one basket. But we cannot afford to do that. If the merit of one night is equal or it's more than 83 years of worship, that's more than a lifetime of worship. Bear in mind, somebody who lives 80 years, there is so much of that time that will not be spent in worship. He may, if he is worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his youth until his death, he may actually have worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for 30 years, maybe 40 years, the most, less than that even, because there's time for rest, there's time for leisure activities, so many other things and people are involved in that they're not actually involved in worship all of the time. So maybe less than half of his lifetime is spent in worship. But this one single night can give the person more than 83 years of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is deserving of our effort. It is deserving of the sacrifice and the perseverance that we can put in, inshallah, to witness it. And it does not deserve that we put all of our eggs into one basket and hope that that is the night. It is a small price to pay, beloved brothers and sisters, to make effort on all of these last 10 nights. And listen to the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha. She said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تَحَرَّوْا لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ فِي الْعَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ مِنْ رَمَضَانِ. Seek Laylatul Qadr in the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. This is the general hadith. In another narration, it is mentioned in the odd nights of the last 10 nights. But there are different things to consider. There are those who start the month of Ramadan one day ahead of others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, but we have to make the effort we can. We have to take the necessary steps and precautions as well. So what may be an odd night for one may be an even night for the other. Who knows which odd night it is? So we have to make the effort, beloved brothers and sisters. Again, let us strive in all of these last 10 nights. And we will know for certain, whoever stands in all of the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan, whoever makes effort in all of these nights, he knows, inshaAllah, for certain, he has witnessed Laylatul Qadr. Is it necessary that we know which night it is? No. Allah knows. It is necessary that we make the effort. And this is part of the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in not disclosing this night to us, to test us to see who will be willing to make effort. Because if we knew exactly which night it is, then we would sit and we wouldn't do anything else until that specific night came and say, well, okay, we're worshipping Allah this night. But we are servants of Allah every single day and every instant of our lives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to test us to see who will be willing to push himself farther and make more effort. And also, in another way, it is a way of gaining more blessings and mercy of Allah. Because when we don't know exactly which night it is, we will make more effort on all of these nights, and inshaAllah, for every night that we're making effort, we will gain more and more rewards. So this is a blessing in disguise. The fact that we don't know exactly which night Laylatul Qadr is. But beloved brothers and sisters, this is the time to seize the opportunity. For those who did not capitalize and push themselves or fell short in the beginning of the month of Ramadan, and this is the time to compensate. Let us push ourselves. Let us strive to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam of making more ijtihad, making more effort and sacrifice, standing up in the nights now and praying more salah. So from among the actions that we should perform in these last 10 nights, beloved brothers and sisters, Ihya'ul Layl. We should try, along with Salatul Taraweeh that we perform, we take an early rest and we try, inshaAllah, to get up again before Suhoor in the morning and pray some extra salah. And lengthen our sujood and make a lot of dua in sujood. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the fulfillment of our needs. What we need, we have so many needs, we are weak. Allah is the all-wealthy. And He is Al-Wahhab, the one who gives. He is Ar-Razzaq, the provider. We all need. Let us ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one to whom everything in the heavens and the earth belong. Let us ask Him. And He will not refuse us if we ask sincerely. وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. And from the qualities of the people of Jannah is that they used to stay up in the nights, and especially in the early hours of the morning, as-sahar, in this period of time before suhoor, they used to do istighfar and beg the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us utilize this time to do istighfar, to make a lot of dua, to do the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to beg His forgiveness for our shortcomings and mistakes. And the dua at this time is readily accepted, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, is there anyone who is calling on me so that I may answer? Is there anyone begging my forgiveness so that I may forgive him? Let us utilize this time. Reciting the Qur'an, let us strive to recite more Qur'an in this period of time, in these last days of the month of Ramadan. The Salaf al-Salih, the pious predecessors, there were many of them who, in the first part of the month of Ramadan, they would try to complete a khatma, a whole recitation of the Qur'an, in 7 days, every 7 days. But then when it came to the last 10 days, they would complete the recitation of the Qur'an in 3 days. Every 3 days, they would complete the recitation of the Qur'an. There were those who used to do it even more, once every single day. But let us strive to push ourselves and recite more, as much as we can. As I said, let us make abundant dua. And from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the dua that he taught to Aisha radiallahu anha when she asked him, Ya Rasulullah, if I witness Laylatul Qadr, which dua should I make? He said, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. O Allah, You are the one who is all pardoning. You love to pardon, so pardon me. And from the explanations or the tafsirat of al-afu is the one who wipes out the sin and no trace of it remains, or the one who forgives and basically forgets. It is not mentioned again. And so when we forgive others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives us. And this is also a step that we take. That we hope for the forgiveness of Allah, we forgive and pardon others, and inshaAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us. And from the wisdoms that the scholars have derived for this dua, this specific dua that we make, seeking Laylatul Qadr, is that after all of the efforts that we have made in the month of Ramadan, we still don't see ourselves as deserving of the rewards and the merits and the virtues of the month of Ramadan. So we turn to Allah and we ask His forgiveness for falling short. We make effort, but we still see ourselves as falling short. We don't see ourselves as if we have done all of the good in the world and we deserve all of the good that is there. No, we depend on the mercy of Allah. We do not develop this attitude of what is called ujub or self-admiration. And we feel, oh, I am so pious. I have done so much good. Look, I have recited the Quran so many times. I've prayed so many raka'at. I've done so much charity. And we start counting. No, no, no. We do not count in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Holy Quran, again, in Surah Al-Mu'minun, about from the qualities of the believers, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَهُمْ لَهَا سَابِقُونَ. Those who do what they do, they give what they give, and their hearts are fearful. Their hearts are fearful as they are doing the good, and as they are giving what they are giving, their hearts are fearful that it may not be accepted by Allah because of some shortcoming. Because perhaps the intention is not as sincere as it should be. They are fearful that it will not be accepted. This should be the state of the believer. We have the hope and we have fear at the same time. And when we do that, or when we have that quality, then inshaAllah, that will enable our action to be accepted. But if we do our actions and we feel this ujb and this self-admiration, we become conceited. Or others may do actions and they do it for show. Show others and to impress others, look, I have done so much, I have done so much. I am better than this one and that one. That is of no good. It is of no benefit. So we do our actions sincerely and we're hoping for the acceptance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from everything we do. And that is what the scholars explained, the reason why we say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa. Oh Allah, you love to pardon. So we've done what we can, what we could do, but we still have so many shortcomings. Forgive us for our shortcomings and accept our efforts and our actions from us. So we make a lot of dua, we give a lot of sadaqah, beloved brothers and sisters. In these last days, if we have not completed our zakah as yet, let us hasten to give our zakah. And on top of that, if we can give some amount of charity, then inshaAllah, let us strive to do as much as we can. And let us not belittle the value of even the little that we can give and we can afford, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us, اتقوا النار ولو بشق التمرة. Save yourself from the fire of hell even by giving half a date in charity. Even half a date. لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا ولو أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طلق. Do not belittle the value of any good deed you can do, even if it is to reach your brother with a smiling face. Beloved brothers and sisters, let us strive to have to do our actions imanan wahtisaba. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man qama laylatal qadri imanan wahtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Whoever stands on Laylatul Qadr, on the night of decree, with iman, with firm belief in Allah and in the promise of Allah, wahtisaban, and sincere hope for the reward of Allah, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ, all of his previous sins will be forgiven. Let us strive, whatever act we do, whatever good actions we do in this blessed month, let us strive to do it إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا, so that inshaAllah we gain the acceptance and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us for shortcomings and mistakes. May He guide us and grant us the tawfiq to push ourselves in these remaining days to do as much good as we can, to capitalize on the remaining moments of this month and to gain of all of its good. May He allow us to witness Laylatul Qadr and gain of all of its blessings and its goodness. May He grant us freedom from the fire of hell. And may He not make us of those who leave Ramadan being deprived of His mercy and His forgiveness. May He make us of those who are successful in this world, grant us His Jannah, and save us from the punishment of the hellfire. Ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
We close our program today with dua kafaro. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Until tomorrow, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
رمضان صيام ودعاء, رمضان أمان وصفاء, رمضان صيام ودعاء, رمضان أمان وصفاء, رمضان سلوك وعطاء, أهلا بقدومك يا رمضان.
رمضان كريم كريم كريم, شهر رمضان كريم كريم كريم, شهر عظيم عظيم عظيم. قم للعبادة تلقى السعادة, قم للعبادة تلقى السعادة, تلقى السعادة تلقى النعيم.